seen them arrested. You've seen them locked up.
But what happens when ex-cons get out of prison?
For some lucky ones, they end up here,
where our team gets them ready for life back on the street.
I am former world and US skateboard champion Dennis Martinez. I lost everything, my titles, my sponsors, and my life to drugs.
My experience is gonna help you.
I've been lied to about gang life, and I've been lied to about the street life.
I'm currently on federal probation in Honolulu, Hawaii.
1980, got sent away for a murder.
I chose to be a gang member, and I spent the last 17 years of my life in and out of state prison.
So I was willing to die for my neighborhood.
Follow the lives of parolees straight out of prison. Watch as they re-enter a society that does not want them. Will anybody follow? Watch them struggle to stay free, gain employment, rebuild their lives, and our guys are going to show them how to become productive members of society and our community. Off the street, real life, real stories.
Looking at a life sentence, it's hard.
I was sentenced to 15 to life.
I've been shot, I've been stabbed.
It's a little bit hard, man, because...
Second generation Westside Crip gang member.
I'm stressed out beyond belief. You know, I have trouble sleeping at night.
We have to learn the hard way in life. And me, unfortunately, I had to learn the hard way in life.
In and out of jail because of it.
I can't do this, homie.
This is very powerful for me. Could you stop for a second? Yep.
Thousands of inmates are released to American streets, spreading hysteria, alarm, and fear in communities throughout our country. American prisons are overcrowded, and the government faces a dilemma of financial crisis. Law enforcement agencies are overwhelmed, and the politicians consider this a no-win situation. But is it?
Looking at the state of California, currently our prisons are at 210,000 people. $31,000 per person to incarcerate someone. It's in the billions we're spending.
At some point in time, the light switch is gonna go on.
Welcome to the training center. This is a state licensed drug and alcohol treatment program in Spring Valley, California.
And so here at the training center, you know, we have a myriad of problems. Someone who's done nothing but time, that's all they know, is they know how to get high and they know how to do time, and hopefully the games are over. And hopefully this is a chance for them to turn their lives around, and it's a time to get their life straight.
So we're gonna breathalyze you right now. Are you cool with that?
Dude, you guys are always messing with me. It's always something with you guys.
Come on, man. Is that what you think?
Is that what I think?
Is that what you think?
That's what I think.
You don't think we're trying to help you?
I don't wanna go to prison for life, man. I really don't. No, I'm better than that. I really am.
I became homeless. I slept underneath the bridge. I ate out of dumpsters. I sold my world championship cup for $500 worth of dope.
It doesn't discriminate, and it's killing our youth.
What's up with you, little homie? What do you think? This is a little joke.
I picked up 2 strikes for drugs and gang-related crimes. I gotta live my life on eggshells.
It's the lifestyle that produces many, many graves.
Their lives are getting torn apart by this meth and cocaine and heroin.
You know, when it everything was centered behind drugs.
I'm calling a rallying cry to the community. I'm calling it rallying cry, but it's the police, it's corrections, it's the community. Yes. It's the people that are being hurt to gather together and use that pain now to motivate them. Not just to lock people up, but to help them get back to the streets. That's my job.
As long as you give folks opportunities to change their life, then they have to take it and run with it.
Wow. Just counting my blessings. I had people around me who cared. It was just overwhelming, you know.